Hello, and welcome to another Top 5 Reasons Blank is a Badass. Today we are covering the Hylian hero of Hyrule and Termina, Skyloft, and Lorule. It's Link! Now, some things I want to make clear from the beginning. I will be referring to every version of the hero, not just one specifically. If that confuses you, it's okay, we'll get to that. Remember to comment down below who you'd like to see covered in this series. With all that bullshit out of the way, let's get into it. The top 5 reasons Link is a badass.
Number 5.
The hero of all. So, like I said before, there are many versions of Link. This is because the reincarnation of the hero is always bound to the Triforce of Courage and is always destined to stop evil, whatever form it may be, and earning himself a snazzy nickname along the way from the Hero of Hyrule, the Hero of the Goddess, the Hero of Twilight, the Hero of Winds, to the Hero of... Trains? Tracks? To the most iconic, the Hero of Time. The Hero of Time label is thrown on most versions of Link, but that is actually referring to the Link from Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask, and, of course, the Hero Shade from Twilight Princess. Yes, this has been confirmed. So not only did Link save Hyrule and Termina, he made sure he saved Hyrule again as a Stealthos Knight thing. Each Link has saved some region, whether it be Hyrule, Skyloft, Termina, Low Rule, Sideways Rule, in some different way, overcoming some ridiculous obstacle along the way, whether it be the world literally being flooded, a whole separate dark world that he has to deal with, or trainings. The point being, Link, in all of his reincarnations, steps up to the challenge, usually as a young boy or young man, and always pulls through.
Number 4.
The Walking Armory. Link has by far one of the simplest yet awesome collection of kick-ass weaponry in gaming. From the iconic Hero's Bow, to the ever-useful hookshot, to the somehow useful Deku stick, to the unbreakable Hylian shield. It seems Link is the medieval version of the Batman with all of his little gadgets. Need to travel into a hellish landscape? He's got a shirt for that. Need to travel to the bottom of the ocean? He's got shirts and boots for that. Need to lift a colossal granite slab? He's got gloves for that. Need to become two-dimensional so you can travel to a distorted version of Hyrule called Lorule and wait, what the fuck? You serious? Sounds made up.
No, man, it's real.
Okay, I'll look it up. Oh, sure as shit. He's got a wristband for that. Link seems to have an item for every situation, and the ace he keeps up his sleeve, the one weapon that trumps them all, the legendary Master Sword. Wielded by most versions of the hero, the Master Sword is literally known as
the Sword of Evil's Bane.
Do I need to describe it any more than that? Fine, I will. It can reflect all energy-based attacks, reflects evil, shoots a fucking laser beam when you're full health. I'm aware the beam's not laser, it just sounds cool to say laser beam. And literally is the only sword that can defeat Ganondorf. Oh, who is Ganondorf slash Ganon?
Number 3.
The King of Evil's Bane. Link's main enemy is literally known as the King of Evil, or the Demon King, Ganon. In Ocarina of Time, we get a bit of an origin story to Ganondorf. He was the King of the Gerudos, an all-female race that has a man born into it every 100 years, and the man becomes king. He obtains the Triforce of Power after basically dicking Link along for the first third of the game. Takes over Hyrule for 7 years, sends the world into apocalyptic nightmare that ends one of three ways. Sidebar, this is what Zelda timeline means, everyone. Here we go. Way number one! He literally wins and takes over Hyrule, and another hero has to come and save it years later. Way number two. You defeat him, go back in time, and warn Zelda and everyone what he's doing, then they try to execute him in this huge fucking war by stabbing him in the chest, and he lives. Oops! So they seal him in the Twilight Realm, only for him to basically take over that as well. Or way number three, you are ripped from your timeline after defeating him, but surprise! He came back and Link isn't there to stop him, so the gods are like, well shit, and they flood Hyrule. I know this seems like top 5 reasons Ganondorf is a badass, but it's not. And I could do that eventually, but right now I'm just trying to show you guys how awesome this villain really is. And Link defeats him, usually as a child.
Number 2.
The Tragic Tale of the Hero of Time. Alright, this point will be focused on the Hero of Time and how tragic his tale is, and how in the end, he doesn't care about it really. His sole purpose is to protect Hyrule and his friends. So this Link was raised believing he was a small Kokiri child, growing up with them in the forest under the protection of the Great Deku Tree. But Link, unlike the rest of them, didn't have a fairy, and they all made fun of him for it because they're a bunch of fucking assholes. Well, the Deku Tree doesn't tell him until way too late that, oops, he's not a Kokiri, but a Hylian. And his mother sacrificed herself so that Link could live and help get him to the Great Deku Tree so the Great Deku Tree could protect him. And after he's told his whole life is a lie, he's told, oh yeah, can you go save the world? Reminder, he's like 10, 11, something in that range. He then travels into a volcano, into the stomach of a whale, and to help lock away the Triforce, but oops! He does the opposite, and Ganondorf takes the Triforce of Power, and then Link wakes up 7 years later, and oops, we took your childhood! Yeah, remember that saving the world thing? Yeah, if you could still do that, that'd be great. Yada yada yada, temples, bullshit, water temple, blah blah blah, Epona, cool. He then defeats the Cane of Evil and is ripped away from the girl he's most definitely trying to smash as she sends him back in time. But what is he sent back to? He has no home, no place he belongs, so he goes back and looks for his friend who ditches him at the end of the game because... reasons? He then gets sucked into a hellish world known as Termina, where he's forever stuck in a 3-day cycle where he can help people in those 3 days, but never everyone. And even after defeating dungeons and relinquishing the evil spirits that live in them, he finds out after he resets time that, oops, everyone's fucking suffering again. That's fun. He does eventually save the day, but after that, well, he fights for the Hyrulean army, apparently. We know this because his grave in Twilight Princess and Hylians turn into Stealthos when they pass, so the Hero of Time did grow up. So sorry everybody who thinks he's dead in Majora's Mask, but no one in Hyrule knows of any of the heroic things he did. And the worst part? There are people who see him as a hero, but he was never there to experience it. And when Ganon came back, he wasn't there to save those people, so many must have lost faith in him. But is he an angry spirit after all of this? No, he simply wants to guide us, help us, and teach us so that we can finish what he started.
Number 1.
The true Triforce wielder. So, a confusing thing is how people say, Ganon has the Triforce of Power, Zelda has the Triforce of Wisdom, and Link has the Triforce of Courage. When you put them all together, what do you get?
Your powers combined. I am Captain Planet!
The Triforce. Because 3 plus 3 plus 3 equals 9. But a unique trait, and a point I thought of thanks to MC Prophet. Seriously, check this guy out if you like theories and symbolism, and the guy knows his shit. And his video of Twilight Princess is that Link is the only one of the three who ends up with all three virtues at the end. So this is mainly in Twilight Princess, but it can be seen in the other games as well, especially any of the ones with more story elements in them. All three start off with their virtue. Ganon is powerful, Zelda is wise, and Link is courageous. But Ganon lacks the wisdom to use his power for good, and the courage to stand up and make positive change. Mr. I want to get the coveted wins, and I feel bad for my people. Zelda literally gives up when Zant invades. Don't want to transform to your ninja self? Mrs. Top Tier Bullshit? Just gonna lock yourself away? If I be the damsel in distress, I don't fuck care. Me and this little imp girl got this. She's bae as fuck. And she obviously thinks she lacks the power to do anything. Again, ninja form, top tier, zero where you at? And Link starts without the other two traits. He's just a young guy, boy, whatever. He has no real strength. And what kind of idiot would just run into danger like he does? Admit it, when you first started a Zelda game, you had this, I'm gonna charge in every situation and hack and slash shit with my sword mentality, which is awesome because it links us to the Link and...
It all makes sense now. That's why his name is Link.
Link obtains power through his journey, but doesn't want to take over. He's wise enough to know what he must do with his incredible gift, and he has the courage to make the change and to stand up for what he believes in. And to me, that's pretty badass. Thanks for watching. Alright guys, thanks for watching. That was another Top 5 Reasons Blank Was a Badass. If you have any suggestions for people you want to see, comment them down below. Like, share, and subscribe, and all that shit helps, obviously, but, you know, glad you're here watching again. Any suggestions for things you want to see, please let us know. I actually have a new series that I'm planning on doing called The Game They Should Make, and the first one I'm going to tackle is a Zelda game. I have a great idea, and I can't wait to share it with you guys. So, thanks for watching my video, and see you next time.
Next time.